Wait, so this one is free as well? No. I've never even seen this before. This is amazing. All six of these are free. What? Hey, in this video, we're going to share six amazing free resources for UX and UI designers. We've got a list of six amazing free resources, but stick around till the end of the video and I'm going to share a bonus seventh resource, which is my personal favorite. As you're watching this video, let us know which are your favorite resources and why, and if you've got a link to a great resource you can share, put it in the comments. So let's dive into resource number one, one of my favorites, and it's called Growth.Design. Growth.Design is a set of case studies and examples of real products and real apps and how they've done their UX. And a lot of the examples are specifically relating to growth, so things like getting users, keeping users, user retention. And the best thing about this resource is how they show those case studies. They go into so much detail and really explain all the design decisions and why they're there so that you can copy and replicate the same things that really successful products and apps do. So let's take a look at one of these. You can see there's a lot of examples here. There's even more than's on this screen. We're going to look at Duolingo, and I'm really excited to show you how they present this information because it makes it so easy for, as a designer, to see what someone else has done and then copy the same thing or learn those skills of how they've designed it that way. So this is how they do their case study. You can flick through using your keyboard, and it tells it like a story with this great comic book style. And this is telling the story of Duolingo, so I'm gonna skip through a little bit here and come to the interesting part, but they're showing an example of how Duolingo gets users to come back and use the app again. So if I click through, we're going through this story, you can see this great little gamified sidebar that's telling us how interested the user is and why they've, as they're going through this journey of the choices that they made in the UX to get the users more excited. They call it the psych level. And then down the bottom, they've got these goals along the way. So as you click through, you're kind of learning and going on a journey with them. On the side here now, we've hit a bit of a milestone where there's a psychological insight to gain about the way that they've done this UX design. Here that's talking about triggers to prompt users to take action. And you can see exactly the way that they've done it. They've triggered someone because of the certain amount of time they've been away from the app, and they've got really clear specific words. You can see where their buttons are. You can see how they've designed it to get the user to want to come back in. And here's another one where there's another psychology insight, and it tells you the name of that, that concept as well. This one's called Hick's Law. The time it takes for a user to make a decision increases with the number and complexity of the choices that they have. So in your UX design, you should make sure that you highlight one option so it's easy for the user to choose, and that any other options that are there on the page don't conflict with that, so it makes it easier for the user to choose what you want them to do or what you feel that they should do in that situation. So the style and the detail of these examples is an amazing resource for any UX designer to come and learn how other really successful apps became successful from specific UX design choices. So that first resource was Growth.Design. It's completely free to access all of these great case studies and examples, and you can sign up to their mailing list to get them directly into your inbox, and they release new examples and case studies every couple of months. So I hope you enjoyed that one. Let us know in the comments what you think of Growth.Design. And let's jump into resource number two. This one is called Mobbin.Design. And it's a great resource for seeing tons of examples of different app screens and all the really popular ones and things that you'll know. And you can browse, for example, by category. So you can find business apps, entertainment apps, food apps. Let's have a look at music apps. And you can see that we've got SoundCloud here, Spotify, and we can actually look into those apps, how they do their login and onboarding, how Spotify here, for example, does their music discovery, organizes their playlists, how the play button works, what it looks like when a song is playing or paused. You can get all this great inspiration of how other successful apps have done similar features and functions that you're trying to think about how to do. So if you want to practice your design skills and practice designing particular features or styles or patterns, you can take these images and recreate them yourself to practice how to create the examples that we're seeing here. So you can see, for example, how they've laid out the navbar, how they've organized the list, how much space is in between each item, the font sizes of the text in those items to make them really readable, all the things that feel really difficult when you actually try and do them from scratch all on your own are a lot simpler when you can see the real world example of how other world-leading designers have designed something that you're trying to do yourself. So that was Mobbin.Design, where you can look at tons of apps and learn from commonly used design patterns and practice them yourself. So let's look at resource number three. This is a design blog from Adobe called XD Ideas. So this is a blog with tons and tons of amazing articles about different UX and UI processes, principles like app design, design systems, emerging technology, different perspectives, so unique opinions and insights on design. And if we look through really quickly here, we can see things like what is inclusive design, principles and examples, your web design review process, best practices for virtual reality. So you can see that there's a really diverse and wide range of articles, and they're all written by experts in the field. So you know that you can come to look at the XD Ideas blog from Adobe and get really great insights that are going to help you with your design process. So if we have a look at something specific, so for example, design systems will be really useful to you as a UX UI designer. And you can see here they give an overview of what that principle is, and then there's multiple articles talking about that particular subject. And we can see that it's also beautiful to read. There's great illustrations. It's beautifully laid out and designed. So you could really see yourself spending hours reading these articles. As I'm scrolling now, I really want to read this What is Inclusive Design? Principles and Examples. Also, design inspiration for UX and UI workflows. As a designer, this is a goldmine of expert information and opinions about things that I need to know to be a great designer. So that was free resource number three, Adobe's XD Ideas blog. And onto resource number four. This is called User Onboarding, which is a lot of really detailed examples of how other apps have done their onboarding experience. So it's really similar to Growth.Design, but really just focused on showing detailed, clear examples of how other companies have designed their onboarding experience. And you can see how they've made their decisions and exactly what copy, text, and elements they've chosen to put into their onboarding experience for the particular goals they were trying to achieve. So have a quick look at one example at Dropbox. And the way they've laid out their information is also in a story similar to Growth.Design. So you can really see why they've decided to put particular text and elements on the screen, and you can learn a lot from different companies and how they use language and buttons and elements and things like this to help specifically help a user onboard and understand how to use their product. So that was User Onboarding. Great specific examples of how other apps and services have designed their user onboarding flows. And on to resource number five, which is Product Hunt. It's a huge library of almost every single digital product that exists in the world. So this is a great resource for getting inspiration and just seeing what's out there and how different companies and apps do things a bit differently in the same field. If you're starting a project around a particular area, you can come to Product Hunt and search for that particular thing. For example, travel. If you are starting a project in travel, you can come here, search for travel, and you can see an almost endless list of other apps and products around travel. So this is a great way to get inspiration and see all the different ways that people are doing something that you're thinking about working on. See huge lists of companies that you might not have thought of or maybe not even heard of, and really get a feel for the space that you're about to start working in. So you can look at the particular products and services and see a bit more about them, how their screens are designed, and a little bit more about the company and the product in general. So that was Product Hunt. And on to the last resource, number six, which is Previewed. And this is a great resource to make your mobile UI designs really pop. How it works is you can upload images of your screens or UI designs, and it puts them into a 3D animated phone case, which you can change the color, the style, the type of phone, and you can then use these in your portfolio or presentations to showcase your work and make them look really professional. It's a really great resource, and it can give you 2D images, 3D snapshots, or those 3D moving animations. The only thing about this one is that you can just export one image per week in the free version. So because this is a list of free resources, we want to make that clear that this is a fantastic resource that will make your work look really professional, but the free version is limited. So that was previewed, and that was the sixth and final resource. But now I'd love to share with you my personal favorite bonus resource, number seven, which is Figma templates. Figma is a design tool where you can create UX wireframes and UI designs, but this resource is the templates, the pre-made templates that you can download and use yourself, so you don't have to start from scratch when building those wireframes and UI designs. There's a huge list of templates that have been uploaded from designers all around the world. So there's wireframe kits, UI kits for mobile, web, desktop. So you can use these kits and it will save you a lot of time, plus you can learn along the way. So that was Figma templates, one of my personal favorite resources that I really wanted to share with you, and I hope you find it as useful as I do. So I hope you enjoyed that list of free UX and UI design resources. I'd love to know what your favorite resources are. Please share a link in the comments below. And we'd love to know which of the resources that we shared is your favorite and why. If you'd like to see more videos about UX and UI design, subscribe to the Career Foundry channel. We've got more videos just like this coming out every week. And if you're interested in getting started in either UX or UI design, Career Foundry have two great free short courses, and you can sign up to either of those via the link in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed these resources, and we'll see you again soon. All this great inspiration of how, I haven't looked at this at all. Why they've made those decisions and how it turns and.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.